one of those kids who always knew what I wanted. They took me down to the airport to see all the planes depart, and watching them fly, or something inside of me was starting. I was 8 when I told them that I'd be a pilot, but I was too young and too short, and there were no female captains. And my dad said, be patient, he said, just see what happens. But I took my first lesson, came down from the sky, and told my father I'd fly for the rest of my life. Then I got my first job, flying for a mortician in a tiny bonanza, just a corpse and me. $5 an hour for flying dead bodies. I had to climb over their faces just to get to my seat. Then suddenly the wheels lift off, the ground is falling backwards. I am suddenly alive. Suddenly I'm in the cockpit. Suddenly everything's changed. Suddenly I'm not too young or too short, and the passengers in the back don't complain. Hey lady, hey baby, hey, why don't you grab us a drink? And the flight attendants weren't my friends back then, and they said, are you better than us, do you think? But I kept getting hired, and the World War II crew, they retired, and the girls all thought much higher of me. 1986, the first female American.
Something has died.